No, no, he doesn't want it. He used to, when he was small, he loved for a hurricane to come so he could go down to the coast and surf. And he still loved the water. He did this earlier today. He's crazy. He really enjoys the water of it. This storm really fooled me because normally I thought I was going to get 2 inches of water in my shop, and I got about 2 foot. But normally it changes. What happens when the wind shifts, the tide goes out. But it didn't do it this time because it was in the Pamlico Sound and it was still pumping water in here.
So how would you rate this? How long have you been here, by the way?
Oh, right. Since 64.
How would you rate this?
It's probably about the size of ginger, the hurricane ginger. Yeah.
But, and I noticed, how have you prepared out
Hang
here?
On one
by
second.
The,
Hang
okay.
On let's try.
Can you say and spell your name for me?
Bernard Porter. P-O-R-T-E-R, my last name. B-E-R-N-A-R-D, my first name.
I got 5 minutes to take.
What did you say when I first came up here?
I'm not used to this.
Could you handle it?
I have no choice. I retired and moved out here. I have no choice now but to try to do something about it, you know. I mean, just deal with it. You know what I'm saying? But, hey, that's the law of nature, so.
Well, what did you say? You didn't know if you could handle it? What did you say?
I said I didn't know if I could handle this or not, but I think I can.
Is there cause for concern earlier? You said that you were a little bit concerned.
Well, I was. But the wind didn't bother me, right? But the water, hey, you know what I'm saying? Water, I just couldn't deal with water, but this is where it came. And then after that, it started going back. I feel okay. We have no power, but have to wait until they get to it. You know what I'm saying? But I think everybody's working. And it seemed like everything is going.
How would you compare this? The worst you've ever seen?
Yes.
Yes, what?
Yes, it is. It's the worst I ever seen.
Right. Thank you so much. Actually, out there, right, is the road. That's Oak Road?
Yes.
Oak's Road.
No. Here is National Avenue until you get to the bridge. Once you cross the bridge, it's Oak Road.
Oh, that's actually the bridge up there.
Yeah,
I see.
That's Oak Road.
Can't really tell where the bridge or the street.
Right.
I mean, because I've never been here before, so I couldn't tell that this is even.
My friend, we were talking yesterday, and he said, "What you going?" Said, "Bernard, what you do?" I said, "Well, I'm gonna hang in here." And he hung in here, but until about 12 o'clock, the water started coming up, and I couldn't blame him.
But you hung in.
Hmm. Yeah. Well.
You glad you hung in?
Yeah. I'm glad I did. You know, but it would have been much better if we'd have had power, you know, but some things you can't control.
Got a video.
Right by me.
Okay, are you ready or no? That means come?
Yeah.
If it means come, tell him to, I don't know what to do.
Tell him to wave
him
on.
I'm just gonna assume you got it.
Wave him on.
This is Kerry Sanders. I'm driving along the beach road here on the Outer Banks. As you can see, Hurricane Isabel hammering the area, water flowing down the street here. I'm now crossing, well, you can see the welcome sign there to Kill Devil Hills. What's sort of interesting is as you see this water flowing in, just here to that side, if you look, which would be to my right, that's the beach right there. And these are homes right on the beach. And as I come around here, what I'll do is, because I'm protected in the vehicle, I'll actually just put down the window and come around here. And we'll just hold the microphone outside of the window for a second so you can hear this. Okay, that's the sounds of the hurricane as it's approaching here. Isabel has knocked out some power to the area, although you can see, I think, that some of the power lines here are at least still up, although they do know eventually the power lines are going to be knocked out. Most of the residents who decided to ride this hurricane out did not do it this close to the water. They've gone in at least a block or two. This is the road that leads right in. As I look down here, you can see some sort of the foam. In fact, let me hop out. Well, see, I'm kind of lucky here. This is a problem about going out in the hurricane. I'm there's a nail right there in this 2x4, 2x6 that's apparently come off. The hurricane is not really full force yet. Eventually, we're going to see about 105, 110 mile an hour winds, but you can see how frothy it's gotten here. That's the foam from the ocean there. The Emergency Operations Center says at this point, things are running well, at least in terms of rescues. They've not had to send anybody out to do any sort of rescues. It appears that everybody is treating this storm seriously. In fact, we're going to head back in now because I fear that as we hear the storm getting stronger, and we have the fortunate technology of the loop telling us that that hurricane is getting here even closer, we're going to get in before those hurricane force winds arrive. Kerry Sanders, NBC News on the Outer Banks of North Carolina. Whoa!
Take a right through it and get a splash.
Thank you.
to that big piece of wood. You still behind us? give me a three count. I'll come down with you.
In three, two. I want to take you around back of this Best Western Hotel. You can see right up top, this is where the tarp looks like a large part of the shingling for the roof has come undone.
Roger. Yep.
Three, two. I want to take you around back of this Best Western Hotel and give you a closer look at some of the damage. If you look up there, you can see a large part of the roof just ripped, peeled away, kind of dangling there like a banana peel. Oh, you ready?
Yep. Okay.
Three, two. I want to take you around back of this Best Western Hotel and give you a closer look at some of the damage. If you look up top, you can see some of the shingle. You can see a large portion of the roof literally peeled away like a banana peel. Really? Three, two. I want to take you around back of this Best Western Hotel and give you a closer look at some of the damage. If you look up top, you can see a large portion of the roof peeled away, literally, like a banana peel, just kind of dangling there. Just walk a little bit further with me and you can see all of the debris that's now on the ground surrounding the hotel. Yeah, some pieces of insulation and portions of shingles which just got ripped off by all of the wind. And then when you come all the way around back, you can see not a damn thing. Check this out. This is actually a piece of the gutter, which is obviously no longer where it used to be. Three, two. Check this out. This is actually a portion of the gutter, which is obviously no longer where it used to be. If you take a look this way, in fact, look up top, you can see a large portion of the roof dangling there precariously, kind of like a banana peel. Literally, it was just ripped from the roof. Are you okay?
Yeah.
Three, two.
All right.
Why don't you start on me, and then we'll come down. Actually, start on me.
Oh.
Okay. Three, two. Some more damage we want to show you. If you look right over here, you can see a portion of the gutter, which is obviously no longer where it used to be. Now look up top, and you can see this large piece of the roof, which was literally ripped, and it's just dangling there, kind of like a banana.
Like a banana bread.
Let's try this again. Three, two.
Hold on.
I think you're starting on me, aren't you?
Oh, right.
Yeah. Three, two. I want to give you a closer look at some of the damage. This right over here, a large piece of the gutter, which is obviously no longer where it used to be, which is right up top. In fact, if you look up top, you can see a portion of the roof, which was literally peeled away, kind of like a banana peel, and now it's just dangling there precariously, waiting to come down.
Good.
Okay.
definitely what we want to do is shoot him right here in front of it. And I'm going to shoot it wide so you can see it. I'll put a lavalier on him. Yeah, that's fine. Okay, I'm gonna shoot this a little wide at first, and then I'll get a tight shot of his face. All right, you can.
Done some damage to a vehicle. Sure did. It was wild. Upstairs is for. Which her bedroom will be here one day. And we, you know, we have just lived at this property. We've made one mortgage payment on this house. Can you believe that?
So what was your reaction when you saw this?
Well, I cursed. But I was, you know. Honestly, I thought the damage was worse because it shuddered. I mean, it was like, and we were downstairs. You know, this one was built in 88, and this, you know, we've been through all the hurricanes and everything around here, you know. And we've had several, you know, the flood and everything, things in the Rocky Mountains. And, but it shuttered the whole house, and I thought it was worse than what it is, honestly.
Were you afraid to come up here and look at it?
No, I was ready to, because I knew we had to, you know, all me and all the neighbors just joined in, and we were on the roof. In the wind and rain last night, all my neighbors, my neighbor across the road is an attorney. So how can I get a copy of this if it goes on the air?
Well, there's a service. We contacted out to a service. But mm-hmm. I don't think you want that because it's like
$35 to $45. I can just film it on.
Exactly.
When might it air?
It'll definitely air sometime tonight between 5 and 6.
Oh, really? Okay. I don't know. She may.
I have no kids, and I don't know myself.
Hey, Patty. And that's my mother-in-law. Who's Lindsay?
Oh, is that the baby?
That's I've got twins. That's one of them. That's Lauren. Madison is the other little baby. Lindsay, come here. The lady wants to talk to you. They're the babies. Come here. This is Tina. Lindsay, this is Miss Tina. She lives in Raleigh.
Wow.
And she's on TV. She works for the TV station.
Do you want to be on TV?
Thank you.
rooms that have been completely rocked. So much.
Easy. I figure because they're covered in plastic, you want to keep them, huh?
I don't even know where this home came from. Who's, you know?
About one more good one, right?
Yeah. I mean, we could.
Oh, yeah. They said there's a house off the land. most of the brunt of this storm. Some of the newer buildings adjacent to it have very little damage. That, as Don was talking about just a moment ago, the shape of the building has a lot to play with it, and the building codes from the time that these structures were first constructed to the newer buildings have more strict building codes to withstand those winds. Okay, they're off. Let me come back around so I can set up into the wind for you. Yeah. Okay. Some trees knocked over and some flooding down at the end of that street. Might be a little better on the other side, so you're not looking back into the sun, huh? Route 17 that's completely three-quarters to almost completely submerged. Anybody that's along the low-lying areas around these small creeks, they've got major problems. The water rose very, very rapidly. These folks are going to have to wait for several days just before the water can recede enough so they can get back to work. But some of the older structures in downtown Elizabeth City took a real hard hit from this storm. Some of the newer structures seem to have held up a little bit better. But we did see earlier there was a section of roof that was laying in one of those water areas that I was talking about in downtown where one of the city streets crossed. Now what I wanted to make sure they're aware of is that even though that water may not look too deep, if it's very, very dark, you don't know what's on the bottom of that. That was a section of roof that people were trying to work their way around on the street itself submerged in water. So it's just not a good idea to drive through that water at any time. And exactly. Indeed, when high tide comes in again, you can expect those water levels to start to increase. But that's exactly what I was talking about. You can see that section of that roof from that building that's immediately where this gentleman's driving past, that's laying in the water. So you've not only got the hazard of the water, you've got the hazard of material that's been blown into these low-lying areas. Yet as we come up, Tom, come up and to your right, immediately through downtown, it's unbelievable to watch them. We're standing up here, or we're flying over these areas where people are pulling everything from boats to their personal belongings, and they're driving through it. It's not a smart thing to do. lot of still flooding remains here in Elizabeth City. I know 158 is a major artery, and so basically the only way to get out of Elizabeth City headed northbound. A lot of people use that roadway, but they really should find an alternate way around it. I'm looking almost immediately down below, and they could avoid that driving through that water by going one block south, going four blocks over, one block north, or put you right back on 158 without even having to cross through that water. Okay. Okay.